Good morning, good evening, wherever you are tuning in here on episode number 39 of Farming Simulator 22, Rags to Riches, with your host, myself, JayMorano. I hope you guys are well. I hope you guys are ready for episode 39. Before we begin, just some show notes that I have written down. I actually have zero written down. We're going to go with an off-the-cuff episode, just kind of whatever. My thinking is, and this is, you know, this is with no show notes whatsoever, guys. So this is a first for the episode. I did download a new cow barn mod. I'm going to take a look at it. We're going to look at it together. We can actually do that right now. Let's go to here. Let's go to construction. Let's zoom out. Let's go to animals. So I downloaded this, but it's even more. These two right here, and they have a feeding robot, so it like automatically feeds. I don't know if we want to take that much away from being included in it, but it would allow us to do other things, so we might have to. It also goes from 400 cows to 500. So I'm thinking maybe we just go for goal and save $1 million and just go ahead and get this. That way we can do more and we can just, you know, continue on with the progression, continue on with our story. Let me know in the comments what you guys think of this. Should we just go for the 722,000 one that comes with the map, or should we go with the 1 million and go for gold and go for the one that has a feeding robot and a fermenting silo built into it? All we have to do is run the materials to it, I'm pretty sure. Let me know what you guys think. Another thing that I was wanting to do pretty much every episode is at least buy one plot of land if I can, if we can. Obviously, our first goal is 1 million if we want to go for the cow barn. And we may just do that this episode, even before I get to the comments section. The next thing that I wanted to do that I was thinking of, I guess number three at this point, is I guess we'll do some more logging if we run out of things to do otherwise. We've got to finish up that wheat harvest there that the combine did not finish, and we've got to sleep and reseed that. So there's a lot of stuff to do, and if we buy more land, obviously we can plow up some more fields and start growing some more corn, since you guys love corn. The next thing that I would like to do is sell some lumber and furniture, because we just simply have too much lumber and we can't make furniture to keep up with our production of lumber since we're logging over there. So we've got a lot of lumber, planks, I should say, to sell. That'll get us closer to 1 mil, in our bank account. Right now we're sitting at 353,000 if you're watching on TikTok. By the way, if you want the full view, I'm going to say it just at the beginning of the episode, just to say this for the TikTokers. Come on over to YouTube. You'll get the full view. And you'll also get the full episode. You can come back anytime. If you want to watch 5 minutes, you can come back and then watch five more minutes. You don't have to wait a full day to continue episode 39. You know what I'm saying? Like on TikTok. The next thing that I had thought about when I was just brainstorming with Jake and things to do, he's like, man, you need some equipment sheds. So we may finally make the equipment sheds that we've been needing to make. So very first thing, we need to get this AI back rolling. And it looks like, where's the Big Mac Daddy? He's over here. So very first thing, just to hang out with you guys and let you know what's going to happen. Today is Monday for me. You guys should see this later tonight if I can get everything lined out and worked up the way I want to. I'm not sure how long the episode will be. It may be a short one. I do have another plumber coming. I got ghosted by the last plumber, even after I did most of the work by digging. Here's what I think happened. He didn't think that I would actually dig the hole. And he was like, oh, hey, I'll get him, because he's going to start digging and be like, oh, man, this is hard work, and quit like most people do. Well, little did he know that I was going to dig the dang hole. You know what I mean? Like, I'm saving the money. So he quoted me to install an access $250. Well, we called around and couldn't find out that's their cost just to get the parts to put access to your septic tank in. So he was probably thinking, oh, I'm going to show up and he's going to have maybe, you know, started digging, and be like, oh crap. And so when he left, I mean, he's never been back, never will come back. He's not responding to Mrs. JayMorano's texts or calls or nothing. So I would say that you can pretty much guess that was what happened. And he's like, well, crap. Because his reaction when he showed up and was like, hey, have you got the hole dug yet? And I was like, yeah, it's dug. And he's like, oh, you know, like you know the reaction you get when somebody's like, darn, I didn't think you would actually do it. So I think that's what happened. So they're coming today. We got another company. They're saying it's actually probably going to be about 800 by the time they do everything that they need to do. And I was like, okay, whatever. So, yeah, that's where my money's going currently. And no, none of the money that you guys make this channel from ads, none of the money that you guys subscribe to Patreon on, this is all coming out of my pocket from my full-time job. So I will never use YouTube money unless I go full-time. Then obviously I have to pay my bills, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I'll never use any donation money, anything like that, any of the server money for anything other than what it's for, which is making custom maps, mods for this playthrough and for the community. And of course the community servers, in which I also have to get set up probably today or tomorrow. We did get enough Patreon supporters to make at least one server and have that paid for every month. So we'll get that started. Let's go ahead and dump this flower while we're at it. And that should give him enough space to go ahead and do this up. Let's go ahead and let's see here. We've got a lot of baling to do. So I guess we'll just go ahead and get this done first and out of the way. We'll go ahead and bale. Let's see. Do we have enough hay? Yeah, we've got 1.4 million liters of hay. So almost 1.5 and then 1.2 of these. So I think we just don't mind with the hay because this is grass, and I think we just go full on silage bales and we can sell these as well. Are they silage yet? They are not. They're only fermented 8% of the way. So let's fire up the New Holland. Actually, for this episode, we're going to switch it over to the Big Bertha. So I'm going to go ahead, switch over to the Big Bertha, get those off of him, and get these off of the New Holland. And I may have to shut the thing here. I'm going to go ahead and we're going to hop straight into a time lapse and just get rolling. And I will see you guys as soon as we're done with this time lapse, just to start the episode off, just to get this tedious work done, because I haven't had time working to live stream or do any of the between the episode stuff. So that being said, I'll see you guys after the time lapse. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are arriving with our first load of silage we're going to be selling. Now, I was going to save these, but we need the money to go from $331,000 to $1 million to be able to upgrade our cow farm. And I wish that the only design flaw of this sale area is that they have this little of a sale point for silage and like trailer loads of stuff. All right, let's go ahead and sell here. All right, and that is it for our first load. That brings our total up to $450,271. We're halfway there to the cow barn that I want to buy. And I'm probably, the cows that we have in there, we don't want to sell. But I would like to have that spot be where the new cow barn is. Or, how are we going to do this? Because, we have come to a, if you would call it a debacle, I suppose. We might need to make a little bit over $1 million, because where that barn is, the next barn is going to be a lot larger than it. So maybe what we do is we basically take over that half of the grass field over there. I mean, that could be an option. Or we make a little bit over $1 million and buy this plot and go with that. We'll take a look at the map here in a second. I moved everything down here while they were fermenting, so I could do some plow work off camera. Yeah, let me go over here, pick up what we need to pick up. All right, let's take a look at the map real quick. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so we already own field 11. I really don't want to move the entire cow operation again. But here's what I'm talking about. And let's go up into camera mode here. So this little bitty cow barn will be sold and deleted, right? I would like to move all the cattle in said cow barn, our 80 that we currently have, and move them to the next one. Now, we could install the new cow barn if it will fit basically where this part of the grass field over here is. It's not like we're going to be, you know, losing a ton of grass. We got a whole nother field and a half over there that I need to correct that little spot, but I'll do that later. Basically, just try to fit that. That could be an option, actually. And then we delete that and just move everything over, maybe, like the cobblestone stuff. I'm not sure. But then there comes the problem of the, and I can't just, for those that are about to say and probably have already commented, I can't just delete this farm and then put the one down because we have nowhere to place these cows and this trailer only holds 12 cattle. So unless we just go balls to the wall and buy like 8 of these livestock trailers, which isn't going to happen, we have to place it first and then transport them over, then delete this one, then we're good. So yeah, we may have to do some total remodeling of our cow section of the map, but that's what we're currently facing. Let me go back to the truck. And I believe the sheep are okay. It looks like they might need some food. Let's move this pallet of wood over real quick. All right. Oh, yeah. Let's get them nice and fed. Yep, they're good. All right. All right, guys. Pulling into the shop for a second time. Let me make sure I get all the bales that I can into the circle there. There we go. Let's pull the last few in. Going up for 450K. Now we're up to 571,494. Over halfway there. Let's go ahead and get the next trailer load, and I'll see you guys back at the shop. And coming in at load number 3 of our silage yield and harvest. Let's go ahead and pull in here. Boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Let's go. We're up to 692,890 big boy bangers. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen. We're not that far off. We may be able to do that cow barn this episode. And I know I ask in the comments, and I will read. But I think, I mean, honestly, it makes sense. Like, you guys might not be like, you know, don't get the feeding robot because that'll take the... Dang, this trailer just got whipped everywhere. That it's like, don't take the feeding robot because that'll take away, I guess, the immersion or, you know, the somewhat realistic stuff that we got going on of whatever we have going on that can be... Oh, gosh. This truck has a bad time slowing this trailer down. But we're not going to be... If I made every episode of me feeding the cattle or every in-between episodes, like, it would just make life better. It just makes life better. Oh, my gosh. Can I not hit the bell, please, and auto-load it? Thank you. Just like how auto-loading makes it better. Now, I think in the coming episodes, we may say goodbye to the black bean. I'm not sure. We may just upgrade him to a 3500 black bean. That is coming. I think the 2500, even though it's completely overpowered with 1200 horsepower, I mean, it does, you know, there is like, okay, do we want to get a 3500 Denali GMC? Like, that would be pretty cool to just see new on the farm. We've had the black bean for a while. Let me know when you guys think we should upgrade the black bean. We can do it virtually anytime. But I don't, for me personally, I don't see any need for having two trucks. Just being honest. Like, I mean, there's just no need to have two trucks on the farm. And somehow we completely missed that without the range of this hitting it. Yeah, in my opinion, there is zero, absolutely no reason to have two trucks to drive stuff around on the farm. I mean, look, we've got this auto-loading trailer, and I have yet to even look again at this white one over here that we've had. You know, like, it's sat over here since I bought the blue one. So I'm probably going to sell this off camera and just get rid of it, because there is zero reason unless I buy Courseplay, but then they can't sell, right? Like, I can't make the AI sell. It's just, I don't know, for right now, I don't see a reason for two trucks. And if you guys don't want me to upgrade the black bean, that's fine too. To a 3500, we'll just stick with the 2500. But yeah, I'm just saying that is an option. But let's go ahead and see where this gets us. I'm going to guesstimate that it gets us in the 800Ks. And then we'll just move over to either some lumber selling, which I wanted to do anyway this episode, and or some logging if need be. I think we also have some bottled milk to sell, so we might be able to do the cow barn right now. Let's go ahead and sell this, see what it brings us up to. Pull up in there, big dog. And for those of you that are going over to Jake's channel and checking out his series that he's starting, I appreciate that. Let me know what you guys think about it. I mean, I think for his first episode, and I would say he'll have his second episode out probably tomorrow on Tuesday, I think he's doing a top-tier job for somebody that just literally just bought the game and picked it up and now is making content for it. Kind of like how I did. But, I mean, man, like, he literally picked it up, and he's rocking with it. I'm going to make a road through here once we buy this land, because it's pointless for me, in my opinion. Look at this trailer. Look at this. It's just... Man, this trailer's odd. It just bounces all the time for no reason. But, yeah, I'm going to make a road through here. It's just pointless for me to have to drive around, right, when I can literally just go around this field and then park this where I usually park it, which is over here behind the... Bell storage. Speaking of bell storage, real quick, some boring work for those of you that don't mind watching some boring work. We have to put some more stuff in the TMR mixing station. Looks like I need a second bell of this, and let's just have the alt key make us go crazy and go around and around. I'm probably going to move that red barn closer to this, or move the TMR station closer, like right here maybe. Like, right where I'm looking. That way everything is within arm's reach, and then maybe move these two over on this side as well. Because, like, running back and forth with these... Oh, well, look, we just took out the Mac Daddy. Hang on, Mac Daddy. We will repair you in a moment. Oh, my. What are you doing, son? All right. That didn't happen. Just imagine. But, yeah, just running back and forth, running these bales over here is just far too long, and it's kind of difficult pulling the mixer in and out of here. Let's check the food. Okay, they're good. They have more milk, though, so we need to actually load up the Mac Daddy real quick and do a transport of Milkerino to the bottled milk factory. Let's go ahead and straighten him up here. A bit of boring work, but a bit of Mac Daddy action. All right, there we go. Magnifique, magnifique. Now let's go ahead and run this load. I'll see you at the bottled milk factory to unload. All right, guys, we made it to the bottled milk factory. Let's go ahead and back this bad boy up and hit the unload button. There we are. All right, let's turn this guy off. Let's check. I switched him from spawning to not spawning, so let's check real quick. Oh, yeah, look, we're full. So we need to literally change to spawning. We need to spawn all that we have in there, which are 10 pallets. So this kind of, I wish that for this mod in my creator that they would have made the capacity a lot higher to store the bottled milk. So I'm going to go grab the truck. We're going to sell this bottled milk, and then we're going to sell some lumber, and then we should have enough to build our new cow barn. All right, guys. Now, for whatever reason, these are the dropped frames bottles, because every time I have a load of them, my FPS drops like 40. So let's go ahead and get these things sold. I can't stand it when I have these, because I don't know why it just takes such a hit on like frames with this game. It's so odd. Yeah, there we go. We might not be all the way in. It looks like we may hit the millie. Come on now. Come on now. Oh, one last pallet. We're close. We are close. But we also have a buttload of lumber, eggs, and honey. So I'm going to go and pick those up. We need 52,000 more for just the barn. But let's go ahead and load up these eggs. And I'm going to pick up all that we need to grab. And I'll be right back with you guys. Alrighty, guys, we've got a little bit of everything in this trailer load here. We've got eggs, honey, bread, planks, and furniture. I mean, look at the variety. Take a look. I mean, we are just making an all-in-one delivery. Let's see what we can get up to. We have a ton more planks if we need some more monies. Oh my goodness, look at that. It's all just despawning. Yes, sir. Check that out. Wow. And we made a little over probably 140, 150K, I think. Yeah, 150K off that load of everything. Looks like we're going to get caught once again. All right. We're up to $1,099,815 doll hairs. That's right. I said doll hairs, not dollars. Just kidding. Now, let's roll down here and build our new cow barn. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we made it down to the cow barn. I got the livestock trailer ready to go to move these guys over. Let's go ahead and fly up because we are going to enter construction mode. We're going to go over here. We're going to go to animals, cows, the $1 million barn, and from the looks of it, we're going to have to do a bit of landscaping because things are off. But I'm thinking like right here. Would that fit? No, it wouldn't fit. But like right here. So we need to landscape and make all that flat. So let's go to landscaping as well. We actually shouldn't need to. Shouldn't need to paint, I don't think. I think it'll just let me place it over this. But I'll probably paint anyway real quick. Just give it some nice grass and just mark this off. I can draw a straight line with this crappy landscaping tool. Oh, yeah, there we go. Just please do away. Yes, 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 yes. All right. There we go. Let's go over to animals, cows. Take a look. Take a look. That should be good. Now, what I need to know is everything level, or will it level it out for me? That's another thing that, oof. Oh, no. How much will it give me back for this? It'll give me back 1 milli. Exactly. Nice. So we don't lose money. Let's go. Well, let's go ahead and sculpt. I guess we will have to kindly level. It's just so bad. Like, why can't it just make the terrain form to it without, like, it tried to level it here and here on, like, a zero axis and y-axis plane, but doing so brought this level down and this level up, whereas it looks completely, I mean, there's a little bit of tilt there, right? But it's like, you know, I don't know, man. It's just so bad. I just can't like it. I cannot like it, Giants. I can't. There is no liking this tool, in my opinion. Lower, please. And it takes so long to soften this. Gotta love it. Ah, yes. Let's sit here for 10 minutes for one corner. Mm-hmm. Yep. Like, I'm just saying, you know, I try not to gripe all the time. And I know, you know, it probably does hurt my chances at, like, reaching out to them and be like, hey, do you guys want to sponsor me? You know, whatever. But I'm going to be honest, like, I don't need their money or anything like that. I mean, yeah, it's nice and everything if they would sponsor me, but I'm going to be critical of the game. I want this game to be the best it can possibly be. A lot of people are like, oh, man, you shouldn't, you know, you shouldn't say that about their game because they're not ever going to sponsor. Dude, I don't care. If they don't, they don't, and they can't take criticism of their game. That things that need to be better. Like, that's just how it is with me personally. I'm not easily sold out. I'll put it that way. Okay, now let's try this thing. Right there, I think. That's a little better. I wish I could turn with my mouse. Okay, so it's got kind of a pre-drawn gravel, and we'll probably just make this continue on. Oh, look, it's got bale storage. Yo, what? What? There's the feeding robot. So do I just bring that stuff around here? What's this, like a TMR mixing station? Oh, that's where, oh, here you put mineral feed. Yo, we gotta explore this. Let's go take a look. Let's hop down from camera mode here off the barn. Wee. Let's take a look. Oh, great. Hey, look, it raised the ground anyway. Okay, perfect. After I just put this back down. Okay. Yeah, look. Oh my gosh, guys, I cannot not get pissed off. I can't. Let's see if I can fix it again. It re-raised the ground that I just corrected, mind you. You literally watched me do it. Okay, it lets me do it. Oh my gosh, except to a certain point, probably. Yeah, I can't. Like, it won't even let me touch this. This is like where, I'm pretty sure this is where the semi has to be. Yeah, it is. Okay. It's so bad. Now I see why they don't want to, like, they just don't want to invest the time into it. That's what it is. They just want everybody to play the maps that they create. And they don't like, they probably don't want the sandbox style. Don't worry, guys. We have mats pre-made for you. Don't worry. I would love to have an interview with, like, one of the lead designers of this game. That, oh, Talk about content. I would go so hard and be like, all right, first things first, landscaping tool. What's up, man? What's up? And if that's the whole episode, it would just be arguments back and forth. I'd be like, man, it's just, you know, it's just bad. All right. Well, Well, now I need to go grab the Peterbilt, move the black bean out of the way. Real quick, let's pull him over here in the sheep area. I mean, look at that. He's getting weighed down. We may have to make the switch to the 3500. Let's turn off his lights. All right, I'll be right back with you guys when I bring the Peterbilt over to move our cattle. All right, guys, we got the old Pete over here ready to load him up some cattle. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so unfortunately, I have to back all the way in there because I have to be at the cab. Why can't I move? Uh-oh. Something's messed up. Something wasn't right. Maybe I'm close enough. Let's test and see. If I'm not, then... No, I've got to be closer. Like, I don't understand why I can't just have the trailer, you know, over the animal sign. Because I've got to back over this cow, you know. Okay. So, now, you know, and there's pretty... I mean, you could experience that that's a dead cow right there. Why can't I... pick up my cows here. Oh, there it is. No. Okay. Move to trailer. Yes. Nice. All right. Let's move all these guys over here. How many do? Oh, holy crap. We got 10 of those. All right. Trailer's full already. And let's save the game. All right. Here we go. Let's make the journey to moving the cows over. And we're gonna have to drive. We don't have any paths made yet. Now, check this out. We're gonna have to straight up jump this right here. Here we go. Ooh. All right, there we go. Let's move all these guys over. Move all of you. And actually, while I'm thinking about it, should we just go ahead and move over? Dang, should we go ahead and move over all the stuff over here, right? Let's check. Oh, we need to go inside. What's this? Is this where we dump food? I'm guessing, probably. Look at all these doors, man. How do I get to the animal symbol? I don't know what that is. Oh, I'm at the animal symbol. What is this? Is this like where I get slurry from? Oh, this is probably milk. Yeah, no, okay. Yeah, this is probably where I pick up milk. Not sure what that is. Is this door open? What about this door? This door. Oh. That's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty cool details. Oh, that door opens. It's back here. Oh, right here you can see where they have the milk udder milker thing, whatever that's called. And then if I can squeeze through here, holy crap, there's another one. That's pretty neat, man. Now, I'm assuming that all their food will get deposited into there. You know, they got milking machines. And I guess this is where we unload the food, I'm guessing. That's pretty cool, pretty dang cool. And this is obviously where we get our slurry from. Pretty cool. So, can I go in here? Okay. How do I... can I go in here and hit anything to, like, bring mineral feed over? Or... okay, guess not. Let's go ahead and shut all these doors. Interesting. Let's go ahead and go get our next load of cattle. Select. We have 10. How many of these guys do we have? Holy crap. All right, well, we got another trailer load full. That's so awesome. Be prepared to take liftoff because of the trash landscaping system. Why can't I unload my cattle? Unload cattle, please. Oh, there it is. Alright, let's go pick up the rest for cattle. My question is, how do I automatically feed them? Select. We only got two left of these guys. We need 10 more. Okay, now we need two more. We've got these Anguses. We could honestly sell these guys. So we'll wait on those. Let's do these. Move the trailer. All right, it's full. Let's go ahead and move these guys over. Select, move, select, move, select, only two of those, move, boom. 36 out of 500, man, guys, can you imagine? Gosh almighty. The question is how do I get food and stuff into that mod? Because I don't see, like, besides, like, taking the mixed food over, I mean, I could see that. And where to dump that at? Is it just all in that little strip of area? Okay, let's move these guys. Move the trailer. We need six more. Four more. Two more. There we go. Let's take the next load of cows. Probably would have been easier if we just went like full Holstein wise, but oh well. I wanted some variety. Open. Why can't I drive to the back? I have to be right here for it to work. Move. Next load. Next low, we need 10 more. Six more. Two more. Boom. I thought we had all the Holsteins, but I guess not. All right. Let's make another trip. Another trip. Make another trip. Holy crap. And then you gotta go up this ramp right there, son. Holy crap. Alright, deposit. Yes. Those are newborns, pretty much. These are not. Almost there. Yeah, we'll take the Angus and get rid of those. So we can maximize our... We could keep this farm over here for just, like, raising beefs. That is an option. But I'm not going to worry about it. I've got too much with the milk on my hands right now. And I don't want to get into another cow production right now. But that is a possibility for the future. If we still have space, which we're going to, because I want to buy one piece of land per episode if I can and if possible. Let's do the last bit that we got here. Almost done. Don't worry, cows. I'm bringing your friends, and I'll get you fed soon enough. One thing about cows is they are so much work. Like, you guys weren't lying. I would say season 2, I'm going to try my best to steer clear from cows if possible. Because this season 1 of Rags Riches is really doing me in. I'm seeing just how much work, which that's all part of learning the game, playing the game, experiencing it, so I know what I want to do and what I don't want to do in the next season of Rags Riches. Let's go ahead and back this guy up. Because, I mean, there's just so much work. You got to constantly do it. It makes it hard to make any... Like, you're progressing. The money's great. But it's like you cannot not mow and make silage. You know what I mean? Like, you have to do that. And you have to make food and all that stuff. Let's go ahead and actually load these guys up, too, while we're here. We'll take these guys and we'll sell those dudes. All right, let me pull up and we're going to go ahead and demolish that because I don't want it there. And we can get some money for it. 36,000. All right, that's gone. And we can do away with all that straw, that mound of straw that didn't work out. All right, guys, our last transport. And then we can sell the other guys, the Anguses, the beefs that we've had forever. Break, baby. Alright, let's go ahead. Oh, crap. Freaking went too far because, you know, even though the trailer's over it, that matters. Move and move. Boom. There we go. Alright, let's go ahead and make the drive to sell a couple beefs. Now, I believe, let me take a look at the sale charts. I think the place we go is the same place that we sell silage at. Let me take a look. Okay, so it doesn't show on there, but I'm pretty sure, holy crap, what did that do to the terrain right back there? I gotta fix that. But I'm pretty sure that we sell at the same place that we sell our silage. We are absolutely moving, son. And then we're going to also do some logging here in just a moment. Man, that jaybreak sounds so good. Whoa, we're getting off the road here. Corn's growing back. Gosh, this thing flies. Ooh, it's a tight turn right there. All right, guys, let's take a run over here, and hopefully this is where we sell cattle over here. I'm pretty sure it is, but maybe it's on the other side. Oh, yeah, I think it's over there. So we're going to have to do some odd backing here. I think. Oh, God. Yeah, we're going to have to, like, whip this trailer like a full. Oh, man, this is going to be tight. I don't think the map designers thought of selling beefs because this is going to be tight. Let's see here. I'm going to swing it hard. Hopefully the back of the trailer lets me do it. Oh gosh, we're in the fence. Aha, it did it. Select, sell. For 5K for both of those guys, select, sell. For 55.83 for those. Nice. So here we could actually pick them up from the shop instead of like, yeah, that would be pretty cool. We don't want to buy none right now though. We're going to let ours keep reproducing and all that good stuff for now. For the future, we could. Let's go ahead and get back to the farm. I'll see you guys when we make it back. All right, guys, now that we have the brand new farm installed, or the farm, the new barn installed, we should be able to just store. Yeah, there's no way that's fitting in there. I mean, look at this landscaping. Wow. It's truly amazing. All right, this should all tip over. Ya yeet. Magnifique. Please get off. Oh, this is so jank, though. You definitely should probably invest in a forge trailer now. At least two, I would say. Let's go ahead and just bump these guys in here. So, basically, I put these in here, and they get sucked into the cow barn, even though there's no symbols, there's no anything like that. So, that is what we're currently doing, and what we'll be doing for a minute, as I just toss all the bales in here. So if we have a forge trailer and we backed it up here, it would be fine. Man, super strength is so jank sometimes. Yeet. Yeet. So basically, on like a between the episodes live stream, we're going to do nothing but like move everything out of our bale storage into this new barn, pretty much. Because we no longer need the TMR mixing station, if you think about it. Because us spending that extra cash took the need for that away, and now this barn automatically, with a feeding robot, I know, ultra realistic, right? Automatically mixes all the raw materials up and evenly distributes them through the farm. Now, how awesome is that? That's all I'm going to do of hay. Let's go pick up us a load of, or straw rather. Let's go pick up some hay and then we'll get some silage. We may not get to log in this episode because it's already pretty late in the day. And if you guys want an episode, then this is where, I mean, like, we're going to have to wrap it up pretty soon, unfortunately. Because the plumbers came earlier, and unfortunately that just complicated literally everything. Because I was in the middle of recording. I woke up at 4 a.m. this morning to hopefully get an episode out as soon as possible. And of course, they just ruined my plans. And then they didn't even fix the issue, just like the other plumber. Oh, big sad, man. So hard to find good contractors these days. So it might be a good idea to turn it this way. We're definitely going to have to do some landscaping right there at some point. Oh no, not the dual axle. Ugh. Oh God. Oh God. All right, yep. All right, I'm going to get this moved back real quick. I'm going to skip ahead. All right, that should work. Unload, please. Please. Get off the trailer. Get off the trailer. Get off the trailer. Off the trailer. Off the trailer. Off the trailer. Please, off the trailer. All right, hang on. We're stuck. Guys. Well, that worked, sort of. Now, can I just, like, literally push these guys off? Like, without just going everywhere? That's somewhat, I guess. A What am I stuck on here? Hello? What the heck is happening? I'm holding on to a bell behind my camera. Ugh. Come on. Man, this game, like, just with the whole plumbing and everything, I'm not having a good day, guys. So sorry if I sound like I'm complaining a lot. It's just not been a good day. And I didn't get to record any yesterday because of work, and I didn't get to do any recording last Friday because of the teeth. Oh, man. It's been a rough time, IRL. It's been a rough time lately. Rough time, unfortunately. Unfortunately. I'm having to spend money left and right. Later on this evening, I had to spend like $800 on a new computer part. And then the plumbing is going to be another probably 1,000. It's just, ugh. And like they don't even finish the job. I just don't even understand. They said they're coming back, but so did the last guy that ghosted us. So it's like, it seems like nobody wants to do the work, unfortunately. Which I know is a thing with contractors. It's just very unfortunate that nobody has integrity these days. I know when I did some like work like that, like pressure washing and stuff before it became a fad, like if I said I was going to be somewhere at a certain, like let's say I told you that I was going to be there at 2 p.m., I would be there at 1:45 ready to rock, starting to unload stuff. And I would be done and I wouldn't stop until it got done. You know what I'm saying? And I know people are going to have every excuse in the world. There's no excuse, man. You tell somebody something, like, you clear out your schedule and you be there, period. And you get it. And you don't stop until the job's done, period. That's just my personal opinion. All right, well, I guess we're saving every time I hit the escape button. Now we're going to have to get some silage bales on there. Now, I wonder what the silage, if we have to, like, cut open those bales. Something I'm not sure about. Boom, and let's do. Oh, we're about to be out of silage, guys. Why didn't it auto load, please? Okay, that worked. I guess I can just get these guys over. Yep, that works. Pink bales. I don't know why this barn makes them pink for whatever reason. And we didn't even square bale them, but it allows us to convert them to square bales, which is interesting. Let's get these guys over here. Hopefully this will work out the same, if not better. Oh, man, this landscaping. I'm not going to worry about it right now. I can't deal. Let me literally move this back here. All right, let's unload here. Boom. Boom. Unload. Okay, now let's just like push these guys into there somehow, some way. Come on. Go. You can do it. You can do it. You can do it. Whoa. Aha. Now, as far as where the minerals go, is it here? Where'd I put these guys? Do I set them just outside? I can't open that, so I can't put them in there. Right. Interesting. Let's push these guys back. Da-da-da-da-da-da. That's so nice that we're going to have an automatic feeding robot. Oh, my goodness. Look at all that. Dang, it's got the capacity, too. Jeez. I mean, we've got 345,000 hay, 388,000 straw, and 211,000 silage in there already. Very, very nice and convenient. Okay, guys. What I want to do, because we're going to have to cut this episode short, I don't want to cut it here. We already sold some lumber and furniture. I'll tell you what we do. What we do is we sell some more. I'm just going to park this here and grab our gooseneck. Because we sell some more lumber, enough so that we can buy another piece of land, because unfortunately I don't think I have enough time to do much more. It's going to be cut short today. Let's go ahead and run over here. I'm not going to skip ahead because we're not going to have much for today, unfortunately, so I can get you guys an episode out on Monday as promised. And I'm also going to go live later. Holy crap, going too fast. Whoa, holy crap. I'm going to go live later of me taking apart my PC and putting it back together with the new processor, and hopefully everything goes right and well. Whoa. I don't want to be that close. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. We are going to have to cut it short for this episode. But that's just how everything's folded. Like, IRL life has been hectic. It's just what it is, man, you know? I mean, there's not a lot I can do about it. Let's do 30, if it'll let us. Okay, perfect. 30 pallets. Strap them down. Let's make the trip up to the sell point. And then, that'll probably be mostly it wrapped up. Another thing is I haven't ate, and I've been up since 4 a.m., and it's like already, as of right now, it's 2:30 in the evening, and the woman gets off at 3. She'll be home at like 3:30, and if I want to get this edited, and then I gotta tell her what the plumbers did and show her what's going on, tell her what's going on. Yeah, it's been pretty hectic. And then later tonight, so I can go live, I just need to, you know, spend a little time with her and, you know, all that bull crap. All right, let's go ahead and sell one more load of pallets real quick. I know you guys don't really care about what's going on IRL, but I thought I'd fill you in so you know why the episode got cut short. And that brings us up to 243. Let's make this turn. Oh my god. All right, listen. If I'm not caught on one side and I try to go wider, then I get caught on the other. There we go. Oh, wait. Oh, all right. All right, so we got that done. Let's go ahead and turn off the lights here. Let's park here. And let's go ahead and camera mode over to, let's just camera mode up, straight up, and see where we want to buy. I guess, where do we want to buy it? We could buy next to this one and get the one behind it. But then we could also buy this and extend our corn operation. I think maybe we do that, guys. What do you think? Yeah, I think we do that. Let's go ahead and buy the one directly beside our cornfield. 169,000. Let's go ahead and hit the buy button. Boom. That knocks us down to $73,000 in the bank, but we now own this plot behind our cornfield. We also need to be thinking about what we're going to do with this plot, like right behind our barn and sheep operation, because we also own that. And over here we could buy this little plot of land with this pre, what's over here, it's already got some sheds set up and everything for equipment. It's very interesting. It's like a pre-mapped out area. Maybe it's pretty cool. But yeah, we own this. And then we can do some more logging and clear those if we want to. If we don't, then oh well. Yeah, guys. All right. I think that in the in-between the live stream, because I'll have to be doing some testing tonight, so there will be more. We will probably plow out and extend our cornfield. And we'll do some more logging as well. But the live stream for tonight, the first one will at least be sort of an IRL video. I thought about putting it on my IRL channel, but I'm just going to put it on my gaming channel so you guys can watch with me and get all that going. It looks like our guys stopped here. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and finish off this line here. I'll do that actually off camera. Let's close it out in the big Peterbilt with the cattle here, the new farm, baby. All right, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Sorry it's cut a little short than normal. Probably, I don't know. I've been at this since, I mean, it's been a while, and had to quit recording, lose my flow, and go deal with the plumbing stuff and the septic tank. I'll be so glad to get that done. Hopefully they come back and they're not like the other guy and never come back and ghost us and not respond to our texts and calls. Hopefully that's over with. Hopefully all the stuff that's been going on IRL chills out so I can keep the regular posted content coming on time and then do more in the game, in the story rather. Instead of just, I mean, we did something huge, right? We made a million this episode, or 750K, and bought a huge cow farm, or cow barn rather, next, and we got some land. So we did do some stuff, but it's not like a whole lot of stuff like normal. Like usually I'll have like 2, 3, 4, 5 things that we're doing. But that could also be good. You might like that more. Let me know in the comments below. But if you did enjoy this episode and you enjoy the series, to support me, please do hit the like and subscribe button as always. And I will see you in the next one. If you're on TikTok, be sure to follow. But also hit the link in the bio and come on over to the best place to be over at YouTube. All right, guys. I'll see you later and have a great rest of your day. And if you're probably watching this on Monday, and I'll probably have already streamed, but I will see you when I go live.